Hi everyone, it's me Marjo, and today I'm going to be sharing with you some few skincare tips and beauty secrets that you need to practice and inculcate in your daily routine, especially when you're in your 20s. So with no further ado, let's begin. The first skincare habit that you need to practice is double cleansing. I've already mentioned this a couple of times in my other videos, and I cannot stress on this enough. The reason why I keep stressing on double cleansing method is because we usually wear makeup and sunscreen and we have some sort of product in our face. So before you go to bed, I think it is very necessary and important that you cleanse your face properly before you put on other hydrating products before you go to sleep. Usually the makeup that we put on and even the sunscreen are not soluble or dissolvable in water alone. You need to have like a basic oil cleanser that helps dissolve or melt away all these products in your face. So after you put on this oil cleanser, after you massage your face with this oil cleanser and wash it off, then you go on to your cleansing step. You use your gel cleanser or your water-based cleanser, whatever it is, you go on with the second cleanser to rinse everything off. In this way, you can be assured that you remove everything, all the junk, all the gunk in your skin before you go on with your routine. So double cleansing method is very important, especially for me. If you are using makeup wipes, I suggest that you switch over to an oil cleanser because makeup wipes generally have alcohol in them, and moreover, you're producing waste by using makeup wipes. So it's just one time use and throw, right? So you're generating waste, and at the same time, it's a bang for your buck. So I suggest you go and try on an oil cleanser, and I'm telling you, you won't be disappointed. So that is my first suggestion. So the second most basic but also one of the most important skincare habit that you need to practice is wearing sunscreen. Sunscreen, sunscreen, sunscreen all the way. The aging that is shown in our skin is usually just mostly photochemical aging. So all these sun rays and radiations from the sun penetrate into our skin and make it age a lot faster and a lot quicker. So in order to protect your skin from this radiation, you need to put on sunscreen. Whatever the sunscreen that you have, even if it's 15 SPF, whatever the SPF, you put on sunscreen religiously. Sunscreen with 15 SPF or lesser SPF is better than no sunscreen at all. So make sure you put on your sunscreen. So the third skincare habit that you need to practice is hydration. Hydration is important for all skin types, whatever skin type that you have, combination, oily, dry, whatever it is, hydration is important. Now you must not be confused between staying hydrated and being oily. Your skin produces more oil when your skin is dry. So more oil means it will clog your pores more and then might lead you to have breakouts. So in order to combat the oiliness, you should actually use toners. You should actually use hydrating products. So when your skin is hydrated, the skin will not be alerted to produce more oils in order to combat the dryness in your skin. So hydration is very important, and ever since the Korean trend started all over the world, I'm sure all of us already use toners as it is, but my suggestion would be to use toners which have both hydrating properties as well as some sort of other skincare benefits, like toners with hydrating formula as well as with ingredients that help combat acne and things like that. But always avoid alcohol. If there is alcohol in any toner, just avoid it, move on, and pass. After using a toner, I suggest that you put on a moisturizing cream on top of that. Moisturizing cream act as occlusion, so they create a barrier between your skin and the environment, so none of the hydration is lost, and as well as, you know, the environmental factors like heat, or humidity or whatever it is, dry air, whatever it is, it doesn't penetrate into your skin as well. So use a moisturizing cream that acts as a barrier between your skin and the other outside environment. Now, the fourth beauty tip or secret that I've actually been practicing for quite some time is adding products into my skincare one at a time. So not actually using a whole lot of products at one go, but testing out products one by one. And I usually only use products which I feel are necessary for my skin. So it is so easy for us to get influenced by all these people on the internet telling us what we need to buy, what we need to use. But I suggest that before you go ahead and buy all these things at once, you should first try on one product at a time. If you use one new product at one time, it'll help you understand whether that product suits you or not. So I suggest that you don't use so many products, new products all at once, but slowly inculcate them one by one. So that is my fourth point. The fifth thing that I'd like to share with you all is to not be afraid of chemical exfoliators. Now, I've already mentioned this before as well. BHAs and EHAs are really, really, really helpful for the skin. Don't use physical exfoliators like scrubs. Scrubs are outdated. Don't even use them. All they do is scratch our face. Okay, they're not actually doing anything else other than that. So go ahead and get yourself a good exfoliator with a good percentage of an alpha hydroxy acid or a beta hydroxy acid. Last skincare tip and beauty secret that I'd like to share with you, and this is something that I've been practicing for a couple of months now, I think about 6 to 7 months now, is inculcating a product that has retinol in my daily skincare routine. Now, I got this retinol, the Inky List retinol, from a store on Instagram, since we actually don't have this in India yet. I'll link that particular on Instagram handle down below in the description box. The reason I started retinol is because I started developing fine lines already on my forehead. I never had beauty routine before, right? So 20 plus years of just being exposed to the sun with no sunscreen is what led me to have already fine lines, especially on my forehead. So I felt like I needed to do something about the fine line situation on my face. So I looked up and did my research, and the overall conclusion was that retinol is the only proven ingredient so far that helps to combat fine line and aging. So I went ahead and got myself this Inky List retinol product, and I'm telling you, okay, I've been observing my forehead lines for months now, and I'm telling you that it has smoothened my lines. Like, I'm not even trying to influence you or anything of that sort. I'm just telling you my first-hand experience. The fine lines on my forehead has literally improved massively. And it's all thanks to retinol. When I started using retinol, of course, it feels a little bit ticklish on the skin. But then after gradual use, after making it a habit, my skin has accepted retinol like fully, and then it's just working beautifully for me. I've not had breakouts so far with retinol. I've not experienced anything negative ever since using retinol. However, it has the tendency to dry out your face, so every time I use retinol, I make sure that I have extra hydration on my skin, and I make sure that I have maximum amount of SPF on my skin the next day. So I'm just reading this out from this website. It's called healthline.com. So retinol is primarily used to treat the following skin conditions: acne, fine lines, wrinkles, age spots, freckles, and other signs of sun damage, sometimes called photoaging, uneven skin texture, melasma, and other types of hyperpigmentation, large pores caused by acne, oily skin, or collagen loss. So these are the skin conditions that retinol helps to treat. So if you are in your 20s, I suggest that you really look up on retinol and add this in your daily routine. So that's it for today. This is everything that I've been practicing for a long time now. It's not something that I just picked up over the days or a couple of weeks ago. It's been a month, and some of these habits I've already practiced for a year or so now. And I'm telling you, if you actually do pick up one of these habits, you will not be disappointed. Before I end this video, I just want to tell you, if you have any sort of skin problems, remember, nothing is permanent. It will all go away in time. All you need to do is love yourself, take good care of yourself, and use the right products. But whatever, I know it's a lot of trial and error process, but once you find something and once you know that your skin loves that particular product, I'm sure you'll find improvement in your skin. Don't be disheartened and don't be sad or don't be depressed because of skin issues. It will all heal and your skin is very strong. Your skin is doing a lot for you, so no matter how damaged your skin may be or how acne prone your skin may be, it's protecting you and it's loving you. You should love it back. So thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!